Hello everyone, welcome to EPG Pathshala. In this session and module, we are going to discuss about physical, chemical and biological characteristics of water. The learning objectives of this module are to understand the essentiality and significance of water resources, to understand various unique properties of water molecule and differentiate between various physical, chemical and biological characteristics of water. It is a very well known fact that water is essential to life because the biosphere that exists on Earth's surface would not be possible without it. It is the only known chemical compound that exists in three phases, like solid in the form of snow, ice, hail, sleet, liquid in the form of rain, water droplets, surface groundwater, and gas in the form of water vapors. Within very short range of atmospheric temperature and pressure, it is the gaseous phase of water that regulates the moisture dynamics of Earth and its atmosphere. There is a continuous exchange of moisture in Earth and atmosphere, constituting what is called hydrological cycle. On an average, a molecule of water vapor in the atmosphere will exist in its gaseous phase for only a few days before it condenses to liquid droplets or ice crystals to form clouds or fog. Similarly, clouds and fog have limited lifespan and often evaporate away or precipitate much of their moisture within a few hours of their formation. Most of the Earth's water sources get their water supplies from this precipitation. This cycle controls the temporal and spatial distribution of renewable fresh water in the form of evapotranspiration, precipitation, and runoff. Climatic factors and changes in climate further complicate the predictability of this distribution. Thus, the cycle plays a vital role in creating habitable climate and moderating temperatures. Water covers more than 70% of Earth's surface, of which 97% is in the ocean, which is unfit for human consumption and other uses because of its high salt content. Of the remaining 3%, 2% is locked in the polar ice caps and glaciers, and only 1% is available as fresh water in rivers, lakes, streams, reservoirs, and groundwater, which is suitable for human consumption. With this little amount of available potable water, a continuous supply of clean water is essential for the survival and health of all living organisms. Let's have a look on the unique properties that a single water molecule carries. A water molecule is made up of 3 atoms, 1 oxygen and 2 hydrogen atoms. In each water molecule, the oxygen atom attracts more than its fair share of electrons. The oxygen end acts negative, while the hydrogen end acts positive, forming a single polar covalent bond, which causes the water to be polar in nature. However, water is neutral, as it has equal number of electrons and protons, giving it a zero net charge. The basic structure of a water molecule is well known, with dimensions that oxygen-hydrogen bond length is 95.7 picometers, HOH angle is 104.5 degrees, the energy carried by oxygen-hydrogen bond is about 450 kilojoules per mole, and the dipole moment of the molecule is 1.83 debys. Each water molecule can form hydrogen bonds with up to 4 neighbors. The key properties of water are dipole moment, dielectric constant, heat capacity, and its ability to both donate and accept protons. The quality of water is of prime concern for mankind, since it is directly linked with the human welfare. Water quality characteristics of aquatic environments arise from a multitude of physical, chemical, and biological interactions with respect to their geological age and geochemical characteristics. Water quality refers to the basic physical, chemical, and biological characteristics of water that determine its suitability for life or for human uses. The acceptable quality of water varies with its intended use. The characteristics of water can be classified into three broad categories. The first is physical characteristics, including temperature, color, odor, turbidity, and solids. Second, the chemical characteristics, which include pH, conductivity, salinity, hardness, BOD, etc. And the third is biological characteristics, which accounts for counts of specific organisms and group of organisms. Let us first discuss about the physical characteristics of water. The physical characteristics are determined by sense of touch, sight, smell, and taste. For example, temperature by touch, color, floating debris, turbidity, and suspended solids by sight, and odor by smell. The first characteristic is temperature, which is a measure of kinetic energy of water molecules. It is measured on a linear scale of degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit, and it varies with the range of 10 to 21 degrees Celsius with an average of 16 degrees Celsius and depends on the geographic location of the water body. Temperature affects a number of water quality parameters such as dissolved oxygen, which is a chemical characteristic. Oxygen solubility is less in warm water than the cold water. Temperature also affects the aquatic life. For example, trout and salmon, they require cool temperature for survival and reproduction, whereas bass and sunfish do better at warmer temperatures. It influences the amount of oxygen that can be dissolved in water, rate of photosynthesis by alga and other aquatic plants, metabolic rates of organisms, sensitivity of organisms to toxic waste, parasites and diseases, and timing of reproduction, migration, and estivation of aquatic organisms. Color. The primary concern of water quality for aesthetic reasons only. Colored water give the appearance of being unfit to drink, even though the water may be perfectly safe for public use. Color of water body can indicate the presence of organic substances such as algae or humic compounds. In recent times, color has been used as a quantitative assessment of the presence of potentially hazardous or toxic organic materials in water. Determination of color can help in estimating the costs which are related to discoloration of water. It is reduced or removed from the water through the use of coagulation, settling, and filtration techniques. Taste and odor. These are basically the human perceptions of water quality. Human perception of taste includes sour, like hydrochloric acid, salty, like sodium chloride, sweet like sucrose, and bitter like caffeine. Simple compounds relatively produce sour and salty taste. However, sweet and bitter taste are produced by more complex organic compounds. Odor in water is produced by gas production due to the decomposition of organic matter or by substances added to the wastewater. It is measured by special instruments such as portable hydrogen sulfide meter, which is used for measuring the concentration of hydrogen sulfide. Some examples of odor producing substances are amines, ammonia, diamines, mercaptans, organic sulfides, and ketones. Next characteristic is turbidity, which is basically a measure of light transmitting properties of water and is comprised of suspended and colloidal material. It is important for health and aesthetic reasons. Transparency of natural water body is affected by human activity, decaying plant matter, algal blooms, suspended sediments and plant nutrients. Turbidity provides an inexpensive estimate of total suspended solids concentration. It is useful in defining drinking water quality in water treatment. The total dissolved solids is the term which is used to describe the inorganic salts and small amounts of organic matter present in solution of water. The TDS content of water is defined as the residue remaining after evaporation of the water and drying the residue to a constant weight at 103 degrees Celsius to 105 degrees Celsius. The principal constituents of TDS are usually calcium, magnesium, sodium and potassium cations and carbonate, bicarbonate, chloride, sulfate and nitrate anions. Soluble solids, that is silt and heavy organic solids, are those that settle under the influence of gravity. However, suspended solids are classified based on particle size and retention of these on standard glass fiber filters. The significance of suspended solids in water is great on a number of grounds. The solids may in fact consist of algal growths leading to severe eutrophic conditions in any water body. Deposition of these on bed of rivers and lakes may give rise to septic and offensive conditions, and they may indicate the presence of unsatisfactory sewage effluent discharges. Now we will discuss about the chemical characteristics of water. The health concerns which are associated with chemical constituents of drinking water arise mainly from their ability to cause adverse health effects. There are few chemical constituents of water that can lead to health problems resulting from even a single exposure. An appreciable number of serious health concerns may occur as a result of chemical contamination of drinking water. The major chemical properties of the water are now being discussed, and the first one is pH, which is a negative log of hydrogen ion concentration. It is actually a measure of how acidic or basic the water is. The pH scale is logarithmic and ranges from 0 for very acidic to 14 for very alkaline water. For each whole number increase, the hydrogen ion concentration decreases tenfold, and for each whole number increase, the hydrogen ion concentration decreases tenfold and the water becomes less acidic. The most frequently encountered range of pH of fresh water is 6.5 to 8. Changes in pH may alter the concentration of other substances in water to a more toxic form. Ammonia toxicity, chlorine disinfection efficiency, and metal solubility all are subjective to changes in pH value. Electrical conductivity is basically the ability of water to conduct an electric current as a result of breakdown of dissolved solids into positively and negatively charged ions. The major positively charged ions include potassium, sodium, calcium, and magnesium. The major negatively charged ions in water are chloride, sulfate, carbonate and bicarbonate. Nitrates and phosphates are the minor contributors to electrical conductivity, although they are very important biologically. Conductivity will vary with the water source, for example groundwater, water drained from agricultural fields, municipal wastewater, rainfall. Therefore, conductivity can indicate groundwater seepage or sewage leak. The next characteristic is salinity, which is a measure of the amount of salts in the water. Because dissolved ions increase salinity as well as conductivity of any solution, the two measures are interrelated. Salt affect the quality of water used for irrigation or drinking purpose. They also have a critical influence on aquatic biota, as every kind of organism has a typical salinity range and type of salt that it can tolerate. For example, cladocerans, the water flias, are far more sensitive to potassium chloride than sodium chloride at the same concentration. The alkalinity of natural water is a measure of the capacity of water to neutralize acids, and thereby it reflects its buffer capacity. It is generally attributed to the presence of bicarbonates, carbonates, and hydroxides. Alkalinity is important for fish and aquatic life because they function best in a range of 6 to 9 pH. Alkalinity in streams is influenced by rocks and soils, salts, certain plant activities, industrial wastewater discharges. Oligotrophic lakes with low nutrient content tend to have lower alkalinity, while eutrophic lakes with high nutrient levels have a tendency of higher alkalinity. When a water sample is observed to be producing poor lather with soap and scum, it is said to be hard water. Hardness is the natural characteristic of water which can enhance its palatability and consumer acceptability for drinking purposes. The hardness of water is due to the presence of calcium and magnesium minerals that are naturally present in the water. The hardness is made up of two parts: temporary, the carbonate hardness, and permanent, the non-carbonate hardness. The temporary hardness of water can easily be removed by boiling the water. Hardness is expressed in milligram per liter as calcium carbonate. The water is said to be soft if it has hardness in the range of 0 to 100 milligram per liter as calcium carbonate, moderate if the range is between 100 to 200 milligram per liter as calcium carbonate, and so on. The extremely hard water has a range of hardness falling between 500 to 1000 milligram per liter as calcium carbonate. There are various kinds of trace ions in water supply that influence chemical nature and account for the bulk of natural water mineral content. Most of the dissolved inorganic chemicals in fresh water occur as ions. These ions come in water body from atmospheric depositions, rock weathering, runoff, etc. The main ionic species of natural water are sodium, potassium, calcium, and magnesium, and the anions constitute chloride, sulfate, carbonates, bicarbonates, and nitrates, as discussed earlier. Sodium may be of health significance to individuals. Sodium salts are generally highly soluble in water and are leached from the terrestrial environment to groundwater and surface water. Potassium is an essential nutrient element in drinking water supplies, but in its excessive quantities, it acts as a laxative. Calcium is essential to human nutrition and a key element in the formation of teeth and bones. It is also known as limestone and is a cause of water hardness. Magnesium is one of the most common elements in the earth crust. Sulfates of magnesium at very high concentrations may have laxative effect on some people. Chloride in drinking water is generally not harmful to human health, except when present in high concentration that may be injurious to heart and kidney patients. Water with objectionable sulfate content may have a bitter taste. It also contributes to odor problems. Excessive bicarbonate adds to salinity and total solid content of water, while carbonate content of water can also be considered as temporary water hardness. Nitrates, even at low concentration, can cause health problems to infants of 6 months of age or less and pregnant women by affecting the oxygen carrying capacity of the blood. Heavy metal refers to any metallic chemical element that has a relatively high density and toxicity at low concentration. Some major examples of heavy metals are mercury, cadmium, arsenic, chromium, nickel, copper, cobalt, and lead. Heavy metals are basically the natural components of geological environment. They enter the human body via food, drinking water, and air to small extent. Some heavy metals, for example copper, selenium, zinc, are necessary to keep up the metabolism of human body as trace elements. However, they can be very poisonous at higher concentrations, leading to various serious health diseases. The chemical characteristic of water with high importance is dissolved oxygen, that can be expressed as the amount of gaseous oxygen dissolved in an aqueous solution. It gets into water by diffusion from the surrounding air, by aeration, that is rapid movement, and as a waste product of photosynthesis. The oxygen in dissolved form is needed by most aquatic organisms for their survival and growth. Organisms such as trout and stoneflies require high amount of dissolved oxygen, while some others like catfish, worms, dragonflies can survive in somewhat lower amount. The absence of enough amount of oxygen in water can lead to deaths of adults and juveniles, reduction in growth, failure of eggs or larvae to survive, change of species present in a given water body. The hypoxic conditions in water body, that is DO, when measured is less than 3 mg per liter, causes reduced cell functioning and disrupts circulatory fluid balance in aquatic system, eventually leading to death. The next important characteristic is biochemical oxygen demand, which is the amount of dissolved oxygen required by aerobic biological organisms to degrade the organic matter present in water body at certain temperature over a specific time period. It is widely used as an indication of the organic quality of water and thus representing the pollution load. It is most commonly expressed in milligrams of oxygen consumed per liter of sample during 5 days of incubation at 20 degrees Celsius and symbolically represented as BOD5. When organic matter decomposes, microorganisms such as bacteria and fungi, they feed upon this decaying material and eventually the matter becomes oxidized. The harder the microorganisms work, the more oxygen will be used up, giving a high measure of BOD, leaving less oxygen for other life in water. Chemical oxygen demands determine the quantity of oxygen required to oxidize the organic matter present in water body under specific conditions of oxidizing agent, temperature and time. It is an important water quality parameter as it provides an index to assess the effect of discharged wastewater that it will have on the receiving environment. Higher COD levels represent the presence of greater amount of oxidizable organic material in the sample, the degradation of which eventually will again lead to hypoxic conditions in the water body. The third category of water characteristics is its biological characteristics, which includes microbial contamination and presence of fecal matter. Microbial contamination is one of the major concerns of water quality. Many types of microorganisms are naturally present in the water, including protozoans, bacteria, viruses, and helminthes. Fecal matter constitutes coliform bacteria, total coliform bacteria, fecal coliform bacteria, and E. coli are all considered indicators of water contaminated with fecal matter. Total coliform bacteria are an entire group of bacterial species that are generally similar to and include the species of E. coli. Fecal coliform bacteria are basically the coliform bacteria that do live in fecal matter, including but not limited to the species of E. coli. Most of the fecal coliform cells found in fecal matter are E. coli. Untreated sewage, poorly maintained septic systems, unscooped pet waste, and farm animals with access to water bodies can cause high levels of fecal coliform bacteria to appear in and make the water unhealthy. If we talk about Indian scenario, the availability, quality and management of freshwater resources is one of the most concerning environmental challenges of national importance in India. To overcome these challenges, Central Pollution Control Board of Government of India is playing a pivotal role. CPCB has established a network of 2,500 monitoring locations covering 445 rivers, 154 lakes, 12 tanks, 78 ponds, 41 creeks or seawater, 25 canals, 45 drains, 10 water treatment plants and 807 wells across the country under Global Environmental Monitoring System in 29 states and 6 union territories. Water quality of these rivers in terms of pH, conductivity, dissolved oxygen, biological oxygen demand, fecal coliforms and total coliforms is analyzed since 1977-78. The various reports published by CPCB till now indicated that BOD and coliforms continued to be the major water quality issues. The board has identified 302 polluted river stretches on 275 rivers in 27 states and 2 UTs on the basis of BOD level and has prioritized them. Out of these 302 polluted stretches, 34 were in class 1, that is BOD greater than 30 mg per liter, 17 in class 2, 36 in class 3, 57 in class 4 and 158 in class 5. The maximum number of polluted river stretches were observed in state of Maharashtra with 49 sampling points. The only river of Delhi, that is Yamuna, is under priority class 1, a pathetic and alarming situation. So, a large number of water bodies were identified as polluted stretches for which immediate and appropriate measures are required to restore their water quality. In present scenario, the already formulated policies and programs on water quality management are based on this concept. To conclude the contents of the module and keeping in mind all the characteristics that we have learned so far for the natural water, the basic strategies that can be applied to combat the problem of water quality are prevention of pollution, treatment of polluted water, safe use of water, restoration and protection of aquatic as well as terrestrial environment. The achievements of these strategies will further form the basis of policy solution that can be applied for improving the water quality and monitoring of existing action plans such as Ganga Action Plan, formulation and effective implementation of other river action plans. For an agricultural based country like India, the water quality and its requirement are high for irrigation purposes. The major use of water is for irrigating the agricultural fields and for the domestic use, for which the water quality have to be of utmost importance. So, to strive for the best water quality for human consumption, the strategies that we have discussed are need to be handled with utmost care. Thank you.